أعظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بمصائبنا بسيدنا ومولانا أبا عبد الله الحسين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. الحمد لله الذي جعلنا من المتمسكين بولاية سيدي ومولاي علي بن أبي طالب. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك وأناخت برحمتك. عليكم مني جميعا سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر الأحد مني بزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين، خصوصا سيدي ومولاي عبد الفضل العباس. اللهم ارزقنا شفاعة الحسين يوم الورود، وثبت لنا قدم صدق مع عندك مع الحسين وأصحاب الحسين الذين بذلوا محجهم دون الحسين عليه السلام. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله، أشهد أنك كنت نورا في الأصناف الشامخة والأرحام المطهرة، لم تنجسك الجاهلية لأنجاسها، ولم تلبسك من مدلهمات ثيابها، وأشهد أنك من دعائم الدين وأركان المؤمنين، وأشهد أنك البر التقي الرزي الزكي الحادي المهدي. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. The following is the narration of the events of the afternoon of the 10th of Muharram and the events of the night of the 11th of Muharram, the events that were seen as the most difficult events in the history of the Ahlul Bayt, and especially of difficulty to Sayyida Zainab and to the daughter of Abu Abdullah. When Imam al-Hussein was beheaded, the narration said to us, the ladies began to wail. Imam Zainul Abidin awoke at this moment, having been unconscious because of his sickness and because of his pain. When he awoke, he called out, "Where is my father, Abu Abdullah?" He called out, "Where is my uncle, Abu Fadl al-Abbas?" And he called out, "Where is my brother, Ali al-Akbar?" Imam Zainul Abidin called out, "Where is my cousin, Ali? Where are all the departed ones of the family of Ali Muhammad? And where are all the martyrs of Ahlul Bayt?" The narration states that Sayyida Zainab at this moment, she heard out a cry from the opposition army. Umar ibn Sa'd, after he had beheaded Aba Abdullah, and he had ordered Hurma to cut him Aba Abdullah's head, he called out to the horse riders, "Oh horse riders, trample on the bodies of the companions of Imam al-Hussein." The companions' bodies are all lying on the ground. The family members' bodies are all lying on the ground. The horse riders are getting ready to trample on the bodies of the martyrs. The horse riders are about to trample on the bodies of the martyrs. Umar ibn Sa'd called out, "Trample on the body of Habib ibn Mazahir." But Habib ibn Mazahir's mother's tribe was present. They came forward and they say, "You have already killed our son. You will not allow you to trample on his body." He said, "Trample on the body of Muslim ibn Awsaja." But Muslim ibn Awsaja's tribe was present and they took the body away. He said, "Trample on the body of Hur bin Yazid al-Riyahi." But the tribe of Hur bin Yazid al-Riyahi was present and they did not allow them to trample on him. He went through each of the companions and each of the companions' tribes were present and they protected the body of their son. He then said, "Trample on the bodies of the family of Abu Abdullah." The horse riders asked that which of the family should be trampled on first. He said, "Trample on the body of 19-year-old Ali al-Akbar." But Ali al-Akbar's mother's tribe, Layla's tribe, was present and they said, "You will not trample on the body of our son." He said, "Trample on the body of Qasim ibn al-Imam al-Hassan." But Qasim's mother's tribe was present. They said, "You have says what more is left. He says, Umar Azad looked around and he asked, is there anybody who lies on the plain of Karbala whose mother and father aren't here to protect them and their tribes are not present? The horse rider said to him, there is one bunny on the plain of Karbala whose mother and father's tribe are not here to protect him. He said, who is this one person? They said, there is none other than Abu Abdullah Hussein's body. Then Umar ibn Sa'd called out, oh horse riders, ride and go and trample on the body of Abu Abdullah Hussein. At this point, it got into Sayyidah Zainab turned to Imam Zainul Abidin and she said, oh Zainul Abidin, I hear the sound of breaking. Tell me what is breaking. Imam Zainul Abidin says that this is the sound that they are trampling on the body of my father and breaking everything. He said, the horse riders are trampling on the body of my father, Abdullah. They tore his body into pieces and they trampled on it on one side and on the other. They tossed Imam Hussein's body from one way to the other. It was as if the body had become a ball for the people to kick around on Karbala. Once they finished trampling on the bodies, Umar ibn Sa'd ordered, I want you to go and burn the tents of Umar ibn Sa'd. I want you to burn the tents where the grandchildren of Rasulullah are. Imam Sadiq narrates that once during his time, Imam Sadiq was in his house and the Khalif Mansur ordered that they should burn his house while he was inside, and the great granddaughters of Fatima al-Zahra were inside the house. They set fire to the house, but Imam Sadiq managed to make the daughters escape. And he was running through the house while the house was burning. The next day, people visited Imam Jafar al-Sadiq, and they saw Imam Sadiq cry like he had never cried before. But they said to him, oh Imam Sadiq, why do you cry like this? Because Ahlul Bayt are known to take oppression and are known to take pain. Imam Sadiq says, I do not cry for what happened to me yesterday. Rather, I cry because now I realize what happened on the afternoon of the 11th of Muharram. I cry because I know now what happened to Sayyidina Zainab and what happened to the granddaughters of Rasulullah. They said, what do you mean? They said, when they tried to burn my house yesterday, I tried to remove the daughters from my house and I saw them running away from the house. Then I remembered what my auntie Zainab and what my auntie Umm Kulthum must be going through. When they were running from one tent to another tent, they were protecting the orphans of Karbala, the orphans of Ali Muhammad. There is one narration that says that there was a young girl, the daughter of Aba Abdullah. She came running out of a burning tent. Some narrations say her name was Sukaina. Some narrations say her name was Fatima. This young girl comes running out of the tent. As she runs out of the tent, her dress catches fire. She is running along the plain of Karbala and her dress is burning. Amir ibn Muslim narrates that he came running towards her. When he came running towards her, she looked at him and she said, oh man, are you with us or are you against us? He replied, I am neither with you nor am I against you, but I have some water at least to give you. She said to him, have you heard the verse in the Holy Quran which says, as for the orphan, do not hurt them. He said, yes, I have. She said, have you heard the verse in the Holy Quran which says, وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرُ. And when the questioner asks you, do not reject. He said, yes, I have. She said, can I ask you a question? He said, yes. He said, can I ask? She said, can I ask you to show me the way to Najaf al-Ashraf? He pointed in a particular direction. He says, that is the direction to Najaf al-Ashraf. She looks in that direction and she called out, oh my God, I wish you were here to see how I wish you could come and see the way we run from one tent to another. I wish you could come and see Sayyida Zainab, the way she's moving from one place to another. At this moment, the army of Umar ibn Sa'd, they came and they began attacking the daughters of Rasulullah. Amongst them was a man, by the name of Quli. Some narrations say his name was Quwayda. He was in charge of the head of Aba Abdullah. When they went back to Kufa, he wanted to give the head to Ibn Ziyad. And Ibn Ziyad told him, no, you keep the head. So Quli kept the head in his house. And he goes back at home, and when he's lying on his bed, and his wife is sleeping beside him. At night, his wife gets a dream, and she sees a lady come in her dream. And the lady comes in her dream and tells her that you have the possession of Ali Muhammad in your house. The wife wakes up and she tells Quli, do you have anything that belongs to the family of Ali Muhammad? Quli tells her, raise the pillow. As she picks up the pillow, she finds two golden earrings lying there. She asks him, Quli, what are these? He says, as we attack the daughters of Aba Abdullah, as we attack the granddaughters of Rasulullah, I am God. And when I saw the earrings, I thought of my own daughter and I wanted to take them for her. And this young girl, when I went towards her, she told me, oh man, if you want my earrings, please allow me to remove them and give them to you. But I did not wait. I pulled the earrings out and watched the blood flow. And then she asked, the wife asked Quli, oh Quli, do you have a head in this house? And heads towards the oven. As she opens the oven, she sees the holy head of Aba Abdullah inside. Suddenly she turns around and she sees a lady dressed in black standing nearby. She asks her, oh lady, tell me, who are you? The lady replies, I am the mother of the head that you have over there. I am Fatima the Zahra. And then the night, and then the afternoon of the 10th of Muharram descended into the night of the 11th of Muharram. One of the poets describes that the daughters of Rasulullah wished that the evening would never end and it would continue forever. Why? Why did they wish this? It is because it was during the evening time that their hijab would be covered and not be seen. But when the day came, it would all be exposed. Narration states that at this point some water was given to the daughters. Some water was given as a solace from the enemies. It was given to the daughters after the 10th of Muharram. And when water was given to the daughters of Rasulullah, Rubab left the tent and she was seen walking between the dead bodies. Sayyida Zainab called out, oh Rubab, where are you going? Rubab said, I am going to find my 6-month-old baby. She asked her why. She said, because now she looked around at all the ladies, but she could not find little Sukaina, little Hussein. She was looking around, but there was nowhere to be seen. She looks around and she can't see Sukaina. Then she walked out a bit and she sees Sukaina and Hussein sitting down here on body talking to somebody. And as she came, she said, again, I saw her saying, somebody, oh, Father Abdullah, who is at the very neck? Oh, Abdullah, who is at the third of you with the arrows? Oh, my Father Abdullah, how can you leave me as an old man? She gathered Sukaina and she brought her back to the tent. She brought Rabah back to the tent. Imagine how much Sayyida Zainab had to undergo. In days, Sayyida Zainab had so much in Karbala, and her appearance had changed. There is a narration that they went to Kufa and went to Sham. And as they entered Sham, the ladies all changed and went to Sham. There was a wife of Yazid and it Hind. The people came in the day, we had some people who come, go get dressed and come to the throne. His message got dressed and she came and sat on the throne. This Hind was actually a lady who used to serve the house of Ibn Abi Talib. She had served him because she served him the so he comes and she lives on her own. And there's coming many ladies, I mean a little of Thor and Shaykh of Yazid. So he says, is the Jain sitting down on the ground in the Hisham? And then he asks them, oh people, tell me where are you from? So he says, we are prisoners and we are from Medina. He says, what is he the Lord? She says, what about people of Medina?
يا حسين.